We're here today in the Morris Park community with a pillar of this Learning Avenue and Morris Park establishment for the past, oh, say, 75 years, here with Vinny. Vinny, why don't you tell us today a little bit about how you got involved here at the neighborhood candy store?
I hooked up with the mozzarella mob from Patricia's restaurant. The two mozzarella brothers and Tommy Mozzarella.
The mozzarella brothers, you say?
Yeah.
Does that have anything to do with any crooked activity?
No crooked activity. They're too stupid to be crooked.
Now, well, let's see a little bit of what Vinny has here as his inventory.
We have...
what do you call these?
These are scratch-offs for the suckers.
Scratch-offs
for Amara's the suckers. Park.
I see here that Vinny promotes gambling in his establishment.
We promote motto.
Also, we have tobacco products also promoting cancer. look who we have here. Very interesting Philly Blunts that promotes the smoking of marijuana. So I would say that Vinny should get an award from the community.
We're going to give the award to Michael Finelli.
A.K.A. Mikey Pops.
A.K.A.
Mikey Moneybags.
Okay.
No, but really, seriously, Vinny is going to be receiving on November the 17th at 8 p.m. in the Patricia's restaurant, right down here outside and to the right, the Patricia's. Okay? Vinny's going to be receiving the Guy Vilela Humanitarian Award.
From Vito the Pimp.
Yeah. Presenting the award will be Vito the Pimp. Also in attendance is going to be Piggy. Manny will be there. And Vinny's personal favorite, Tommy the Numbers Man.
Oh, Jesus.
Everybody's going to be on hand. It'll also be broadcast on Bronx 12. So everybody be there November the 17th, 8 p.m.
You offer the tubby bar.
Hey, John,
Mikey, you tell me now.
Mikey,
you
see this fucking knife? I'm going to put it in your fucking forehead. Put this in your fucking forehead.
Mikey, I want you to tell me what you think about Vinny, your boss.
He's a scumbag. He should fucking die like you. I'll hang one guinea on a lamppost and one spick on a lamppost. Get the fuck out now. This guy's unbelievable.
The candy store, are there going to be any new policies?
Yeah.
Yes, go ahead.
Everybody that I don't like is get the fuck out. Simple.
Okay, anything else?
Yeah. Except doo-doo don't have to pay, and you got to pay double, and that's it. Right there.
What they do?
What
was
wrong
with Mikey this morning?
Mr. Finelli was sick this morning.
What was wrong with him?
He was suffering from curry food. He had some curry food that was a 450 out of 20. He had some food that he didn't like. He was crying like a baby. Vinny, you're not helping me. You're leaving me all alone. You're weighing on every customer. Look what you're doing to me. You know I'm sick.
Let me do my return, John.
No, Mikey. I want to hear more about Mikey.
Mr. Finelli was under the weather this morning. Hello,
he was really sick,
yeah,
huh?
He was sick. He ate some Indian food. He was crying like a baby. That's all you do is increase this order every Saturday and Sunday. Nothing but aggravation here. Look at all the customers you're waiting on. You're leaving me all alone.
Okay. Sorry for the interruption. I got to take care of Esther.
Indian food, he had curry and lamb. You're doing this for spite. You're ordering extra papers. You do this to me every week. You were out sniffing all night, and this is what you get? Michael Finelli, look what you did to me. Every week you increase these papers. You don't want to stop this fucking shit. Every fucking weekend.
All right, Joey, take care of yourself. Don't let the door hit the air, your ass on the way out.
Pataki. What did Pataki do for us? Nothing. Klein is the winner.
And who did he replace?
He replaced Guy Vilela.
Okay, give me
what one
of the most
of
honestest men in the Morris Park community. Very honest man.
Okay.
A relation of Vito the Pimp.
Okay. He helped you get your lotto back? Come on.
Yeah, he helped me get my lotto back. I would have got my lotto back in 13 days. That other... Sniffer. He's a sniffer, that Vilela.
Excuse me.
I don't want no bacala. Manny's going to have pig knuckles and rice and beans.
Okay, now if Manny's not here.
If Manny's not here, fuck Manny because we give it to Mikey Pops. That's all. As long as Manny's paying, I don't care. Is there any sniffers or pantyhose smellers around? Okay, this is the end of this conversation.
The sign says easy fucking credit. Manny walks into the store, and not only does he get the furniture, but he pays fucking cash. I never seen a thing like that in my life. He goes all the way to Elder and Westchester Avenue for easy credit, pays cash, and doesn't get the furniture. That's all I have to say.
She kissed me, and I kissed her. Ain't that a kick in the head? Hey. Once I get you up there, where the air is fresh.
John, you show me another candy store where you make them.
You have to tame it at all.
Huh? When I put this fucking pen in his scalp, I'll kill him. That's right. What name is that say on that paper, Tommy?
Help.
635.
Another candy store.
Mike Fennelli's a candy store now. Took it over from Finn.
For nothing. I whoever, shook him down.
Whoever comes with the cash gets the store.
How much money could you get your hands on?
By Monday.
By Monday. 20?
$20?
No, $20,000. We'll get a loan out of the bank and you have the fucking candy store.
I got a real job, thank you.
You got a real job? Alright. Remember what you said. Well, anything you take in this store, you better pay. I'll split your head open.
Hello, bro.
Fucking Vinny. Imagine this guy, Vinny took him out to eat, him and Manny. Took him out to eat. They went to Patricia's, yeah. Fucking Mort's are in his pocket when he goes in there.
What?
The fucking Mort's come out. Just go hang out with the Yomps.
I'll come in and take you.
Hang out with the fucking porch monkeys. That's where you should hang out with. Nah, I told you I was. I was in the Oak Room, baby. Give me an apple martini, chiller with a twist.
Now 8:10 and we're moving the oven for the bread store. And we'll be, when we're gonna be open, Danny? We'll be open on September 13th. That's a good day, Danny. September 13th. We all should be ready to go on September 13th. You got 8 1/4. You got 10 1/4.
I got the quarter.
Oh, God.
Another quarter.
All right, now I gotta put $5 here. John, what do you call him?
Let me ask you an important question. How's Michael today?
Michael Fennelli is totally disturbed for the day. The pockets are empty. That's it.
You're like a character.
And comes, comes the financial secretary of the Mozzarella.
Frank's a good man. He's a very nice man.
I'm some mozzarella.
Johnny Beard, president. Ben. Johnny Beard, president. Frankie, financial secretary. And Tommy. Tommy the Muffer is the, what do you call? What is he? He takes care of the money.
The treasurer.
He's the treasurer of the mozzarella mob. Tommy the Muffer. Goodbye with this camera.
Hey, Manny, say something. So, Vinny, if he's not here tomorrow?
Oh, Manny's not here tomorrow. Mikey Pops eats the food.
Good job coming out, John. Any freeholds on this job? There ain't no freeholds on this job, is there?
No,
hey, watch
no
out. This guy's throwing cement like crazy.
You got the nice guys yet or what?
What?
You got the nice guys yet or what?
I got them long ones in yesterday. They're fresh.
Which one?
The Honduran cigars.